What's up guys, my name is Aussie Marcel, the most luscious locks on YouTube, and in today's video I'm going to be talking about a men's fragrance that is fantastic but flawed, and that is Viktor and Rolf's Spicebomb. This is one of those fragrances that smells absolutely fantastic and pulls huge compliments. The only problem with it though is that it's expensive and it lacks in terms of performance. So that's why I recommend Bulgari's Man in Black. It's the far superior fragrance. It smells like a better version of Spicebomb, and it's generally a little cheaper as well and in a bigger concentration. 100 ml of Man in Black can be found for about $100 here in Australia. I've seen it go for about $85 at Priceline on occasions, whereas 50 ml of Spicebomb costs $100. So you get double the fragrance for basically double the performance and double the quality in terms of the way it smells. Now, that in no way, shape or form is meant to deter people from experiencing Spicebomb by Viktor and Rolf. As far as Viktor and Rolf fragrances go, Infrared is worth checking out, as is Spicebomb Extreme. But as far as the normal classic Spicebomb goes, it's best to be avoided if you can find Man in Black. Just because Bulgari is one of the most dependable fragrance brands I know. You know, both of these fragrances have huge woody and spicy notes. Man in Black is probably a little boozier. Spicebomb, on the other hand, has a bit more tobacco. So you're trading tobacco and booze. One vice for another vice, basically. The profiles of both of these are fantastic. Silage is good for Spicebomb and Man in Black. The only problem, again, with Spicebomb is the performance itself. Man in Black, I put on two sprays yesterday and it lasted about 8 hours. So not an absolute beast mode fragrance, but it'll get you through a work day. Spicebomb, on the other hand, about 5 hours. So you really do lack in the performance. And you're paying more for it as well. So again, I've just got to say, get the extreme version if you have to have a Spicebomb. Or try Bulgari Man in Black. Also, another one I could recommend is Bulgari Man in Black Black Orient. That is a fantastic fragrance and it's got more oud in it. So if you're maybe a rookie to ouds, maybe try that one, just because it's got a leathery, boozy note as well, and it really kind of dulls the stink of the oud down. You know, it's funny because you say stink of the oud like it's a bad thing, but you know, I think oud smells fantastic, but that's just me. Anyway, that's about all that I have to say about these two fragrances today. Have you ever worn them before? If you have, let me know in the comments below, as I'm curious to find out what you think. And until the next video, my name is Aussie Marcel, the most luscious locks on YouTube, and I'll catch you guys around.